We're going to take a look at some of the new edge modeling tools in 3ds Max 2010 using the Graphite Tools Ribbon Modeling System. I'd like to thank Wayne Robson for giving us access to his Frankenstein model for the use of this presentation. We're going to begin by changing out the material to something gray. I'm going to select the model and I'm immediately going to go into my Graphite Modeling Tools and we're going to change the smoothing from smooth to hard so that we can see the topology. I'm also going to go ahead and enter Edge Face Mode, and I'm going to enter Edge Mode, and we're going to take a look at some of the new Edge tools. So you can see we already have some really nice clean geometry here. We've added a number of new selection tools that allow us to quickly create new selections in an interactive manner. I have the ability to selectively grow and shrink my edge selections or my ring selections. I can do loop selections as well in the same way. And of course, we can grow outward in all directions, just like we could previously. Another really great tool is the loop mode. Loop mode allows us to quickly select any entire loop as it goes around the model with this simply by selecting on one edge. Same goes for ring. I can select on any ring and it'll select all the way around the model as long as it finds contiguous rings. Another interesting tool that we have is what we call dot ring, which allows me to essentially skip over any predefined set number of edges that I want. In this case, I'm skipping every other edge. This can be used with incredible results. If I enter loop mode, select one loop, and choose dot ring, and I've now selected essentially every other edge loop in the model that I can then remove and quickly do polygon reduction in a very clean manner without a lot of extra work. Another interesting tool that we've added is Swift Loop. Swift Loop is essentially edge ring and connect all in one mouse click. So you can see that I can quickly add new geometry any place that I want. Truly an artist-driven tool. Another really interesting application of Swift Loop is the fact that I also have the ability to go in and interactively decide where I want the loop after I've placed it. Something previously not seen in 3ds Max before. Once I have the ring in there, let's say that I decide that I want to move it, I've moved it, but let's say I need to redefine where it goes. You notice that we have some edge loops that are off center. I can use our tool called Set Flow to take that ring and essentially reposition it into the middle, allowing us to really clean up our geometry in a very quick and efficient way. This can also be done with multiple loops. So if I select multiple loops and I choose Set Flow, you'll notice that fine adjustments can occur when it repositions the loops in place. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stay in loop mode and I'm going to get some edge loops and I'm going to remove them. And you can see that we've introduced a real problem with the flow of the geometry as it comes to this area. It's now flat. In previous versions, if I go into ring mode and I select this ring here and I choose connect, it just introduces the new edge loop that I would then have to sculpt into place. We now have a tool called Flow Connect. Flow Connect allows us to quickly select a ring of edges and it'll introduce new topology and maintain the flow of the geometry as it goes around. So you can see that all of the extra sculpting that would have taken place previously is no longer present. So you can see that there are many new edge tools that are available to us and they're for very quick, organic, and artist-driven workflows. One last thing we're going to look at with edge loops are the loop tools themselves. So if we open up the loop tools palette, we can come down here and start selecting some edges. So you can see I have some light edges here. If I just select a number of edges and choose center, it automatically centers up our edges and allows us to relax them and really just gain better control over our topology as we move through the modeling pipeline. So you can see that there are a lot of new tools and capabilities within the graphite modeling tools, specifically within edge loops.